HDL Coder generates VHDL or Verilog from Simulink or MATLAB that you can use to target FPGA or ASIC hardware. So we get asked a lot how to target a MATLAB algorithm directly to an FPGA. The short answer is that you will most likely need to adapt your algorithm to work on a stream of bits and manage that stream. Because in hardware you have this fixed set of resources and data gets clocked in one bit at a time once per clock cycle. Whereas in your MATLAB algorithm, you can easily perform operations on large sets of data. In hardware, you need to figure out how to perform the same calculations on this stream of bits while coordinating the timing of it all and still get the right answer. You will be able to parallelize calculations, but you also need to be aware that hardware is a fixed set of resources. So you will need to trade off parallel throughput versus resource usage. And managing your data word lengths is key on hardware because as they get larger, you consume more resources. In the case of an FPGA, which is a prefixed set of resources that you map to, multiplications are mapped to DSP slices, which typically take inputs of 18 by 18 or 25 by 18. So if your word sizes grow beyond that, a multiplication operation on them would be mapped to multiple DSP slices, and you can use them up pretty quickly. Storing data is similar. You need to pay attention to your word length and how many words you store because RAM sizes will need to be pre-allocated for the max needed by your algorithm. So while MATLAB is the environment to manipulate large sets of data, explore mathematics, and visualize data, Simulink is a great environment for adding the implementation detail that you need to describe how your algorithm will work in streaming hardware. You can still include MATLAB code within Simulink, but Simulink lets you express and visualize parallel architecture, it has a built-in sense of timing, and can show you how data types and sizes propagate through calculations, which are all key aspects of creating a good hardware architecture for your algorithm. So our recommended workflow, based on our experience across thousands of customer projects over the past 10 plus years, is to use your MATLAB algorithm as a golden reference. This is what we'll use to verify that your hardware implementation gets the right answers. Add some implementation detail to your MATLAB algorithm. This step is optional, but it helps in a lot of cases, as you will see in the example design we use. Then move to Simulink to build a hardware architecture for your algorithm. Convert that to fixed point in Simulink. Converting to fixed point can be done in MATLAB before you move to Simulink, but we'll show some advantages of doing this in Simulink. Use Simulink's visualization to optimize your hardware architecture before you generate HDL code. And then, of course, to verify that everything works correctly according to your golden reference. To illustrate, let's look at an algorithm that detects a pulse in a wireless signal. In our MATLAB code, we start by generating the pulse we want to detect, which we will insert into our transmitted signal and add some random noise to that we might see when we receive it. Now, to perform the operation in MATLAB, we set up the coefficients for our match filter and apply the filter on our received signal and detect the peak value and its location. This operates on the entire signal at once, which is a strength of MATLAB, but it's not how hardware works. So we'll have to create an algorithm that operates on the signal as it streams in, and for that we will slide a window to detect the peak value of the last 11 samples. Now, for a lot of designs, we could go straight to Simulink and start designing the hardware architecture. But in this case, since we are actually changing the algorithm to one that finds a global peak by looking at a bunch of local peaks, we actually develop and test that in MATLAB to make sure it gets us the answer we're looking for before we move to Simulink. So this algorithm will store the last 11 samples and look at the middle sample and compare to the other 10 to see if it's the largest, and if so, whether it's larger than a threshold that we specify. And getting that threshold right is key for identifying that global peak versus all the local ones we'll get as we slide the window. You might be wondering, if we've created this hardware-friendly algorithm in MATLAB, why can't we just generate HDL from it? Well, let's go to Simulink to take a look at some of the hardware-specific details that Simulink helps us with. The first thing is the data coming in. In MATLAB, we took the whole signal and ran a for loop on it to look at each 11-sample window. Hardware operating in the real world is just reacting to a stream of bits coming in at each clock cycle. Simulink has a built-in notion of timing, so here we will pull the value from the MATLAB workspace variable, and we'll specify to stream it in a sample at a time. And then we convert it to be a fixed point data type, signed with a total word length of 18 bits, with 16 of those being precision bits. But it's a complex number, so there are real and imaginary components. And one of the other things you need to worry about is whether the signal is even valid data. So we use a valid signal here, and for this test we just tie it to a constant 1 to specify that all the data we're giving it is valid. For our matched filter, we can just use a standard digital filter block. Simulink has over 250 blocks that support HDL code generation, and many, like this filter, have multiple implementation options. You can also embed MATLAB functions for control logic such as state machines. And here we use the coefficient variable that we set in our MATLAB algorithm. So you can use the two environments together pretty seamlessly. Now, the word size of the filter's output is the result of each multiplication in the filter preserving all the bits, which Simulink does by default. But for our design, we really only need 18 bits, so we specify that before the data goes into the subsystem where we do multiplication. So now we can fit each multiply operation on one DSP slice. In adding those delays, which map to registers and hardware, not only helps us to synchronize signals to make sure that they arrive at operations at the same time, but also help us model something that maps to a DSP slice, which has registers at its input and output. Here we also parallelize the squaring of the real and imaginary values so we can perform them both in a single clock cycle. Now, in the peak detector subsystem, we have this tap delay line here with 11 delays, and this is how we're going to store the 11th sample window and be able to process them in parallel. Here's where we pull out the middle sample and subtract it from each of the other samples in the window to see if it's the largest, and in parallel we also check that it's also larger than our threshold. You'll also notice that we add the same amount of delays to the parallel valid signal. And these square sinks you see scattered throughout are passing values to workspace variables so we can access those with our MATLAB code. Back to the MATLAB, after we calculate the golden reference results, we just call the Simulink model, which again pulls data from the MATLAB RX variable and writes the results back into MATLAB variables via those workspace blocks. Now we can compare the results, looking at the amount of error between our fixed point hardware implementation and the double precision MATLAB algorithm. So if we run this MATLAB script, it performs all these calculations and visualizes the results right in MATLAB. So this workflow leverages the strength of each environment, MATLAB's ability to easily manipulate large data sets, explore mathematics, and visualize data. That's great for algorithm development and testing. And Simulink's ability to describe and visualize parallel architectures, events that happen over time, and the propagation of data types and sizes through the architecture. And the two environments work together to allow you to take advantage of the strengths of each and verify against each other. So if you're looking to deploy your MATLAB algorithm to an FPGA or ASIC, the best path is to refine and deploy it through Simulink connected back to your MATLAB golden reference.